We've just been listening to the words of Isaiah the prophet, words that were spoken 700 years before Jesus was born, telling us about all the things that Jesus was going to do. Truly amazing piece of scripture. And when we come on this Good Friday and we remember the cross, we need to understand and remember what it's for. In many ways, the crisis that we've been going through has many parallels. This year's been marked by separation, an invisible barrier between people that's caused loneliness, anxiety, fear, and death. As we come to Good Friday and remember what Easter is really all about, we see many parallels. The first one being the parallel with COVID. It's unseen, and so is our falling short of God's standard. The Bible talks about this in a phrase such as called as sin. It's about missing the mark, missing the standard. We're people who like to compare ourselves with other people, to say I'm better than they are, or I'm not as bad as that person. But very seldomly does the comparison go between us and God. Oh, I'm not so bad in relation to God. We know that we fall far short of where God wants us to be. Paul writes, "For all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God." This is a fact. But there's a personal element of this. Do we recognize that we have sin? Are we willing to admit that? Because this problem, this sin, separates not only ourselves from God, but from the relationship that we should have with one another. And there's a consequence. Where God is concerned, the consequence is an eternal separation from God and results in death. Good Friday, we remember God's intervention. Just as we've been waiting for the virus to be beaten by a vaccine, in eternity, the world was waiting for Jesus. God sent his own Son so that we would not have to suffer, to be separated from God himself. But there is nothing that we could do about that. There's nothing that we could do about that. Because of our own sinfulness, we can't make ourselves clean. But Jesus, in going to the cross, paid the debt that we could not pay. Though he was righteous and didn't deserve death, and before God was holy and righteous, he set that aside to take on our sin. Let's remind ourselves of those verses from Isaiah. He was despised and rejected by mankind, a man of suffering and familiar with pain, like one from whom people hid their faces. He was despised and we held him in low esteem. Jesus wasn't a pop idol. People's sensibilities were turned on the flick of a coin. And they turned against Jesus. And they shouted, "Crucify him!" He was held before kangaroo courts and judged and taken to the cross. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering, yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. And by his wounds we are healed. Belief and trusting in Jesus are at the core of our Christian faith. That God made a way to bridge the divide caused by sin, to make it possible for us to come before the living God, accepted and made clean. By his wounds we are healed. Jesus' nail-pierced hands, his feet, the crown of thorns upon his head, he bore for us. The cost was immense, so much so that even at that point of death, bearing our sin, God turned away. We remind ourselves of those verses in John 3:16, that for God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Do we choose to trust in Jesus as the only way back to God? The Gospel of John says, and Jesus says, that I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. There's no other way than the cross to bridge this gulf. But is belief enough? I'd say no, it's not. Because belief is one thing, faith is something else. We need to stake our lives in faith on what Jesus has done. We need to recognize the sin in our lives and turn from it. The Bible talks about this in language such as repentance and turning from our way to going God's way. It's not about earning salvation, but if we recognize what Jesus has done for us, then we will have, will want to live a different life. To go his way rather than our own. So on this day where we remember the cross, the awful pain that Jesus bore for us, examine ourselves as to whether we are following God's way or our own. The story of the cross is not optional. It's not an add-on. It's not something other. It's God's rescue plan for you and me. Are we putting our faith in the work of Jesus Christ? Through his stripes we are healed, we are made whole, we are brought together and reconciled to God at the cost of his own life. It's a somber thing to think about. We recognize that with the advent of a vaccine that we have a hope that is to come. It's not been fully realized yet. Yes, we are getting more and more freedoms, but there is still more to come, and we long for that day when the vaccine has done its job and the COVID virus is no more. And in many ways, there's a parallel with what Jesus has accomplished on the cross. For those who place their trust in Jesus, there is freedom in this life. And an eternal hope to come. But more than that, as we will remember on Easter Sunday, Jesus rose from the grave. He ascended into heaven and he's coming again. Are we ready to meet him? Have we placed our faith in God's intervention for us in sending his Son to die in our place. How have our lives responded to that message? Do we carry on in our old way of life, in our old sin, or do we turn round, turn to the cross, give him our burden, and take up his life? This is the story of Good Friday. My hope and prayer for you who are listening is that you take hold of the truth. If you notice, what we have here is an empty cross. The bridge has been made. Jesus did not need to stay upon the cross. He rose from the dead and is willing to dwell with those who accept him as their Saviour, as their King, as their Lord. He came to save sinners. Seek and save the lost. Are you lost today? Jesus came to find you and me. As we look at the cross now, let us remember the truth of it and praise God in heaven for it. Amen.